What I'd like to do now is step through a statement of a theorem. We're not going to prove the theorem. That's really up to people like Chubba Sepeshvari. But we're going to state the theorem and understand the theorem well enough so that we can apply it to showing that Q-learning converges.
Okay.
So the first thing we're going to do is, just to make things simpler to write down, we're going to say that Q-learning and update algorithms like that are going to update all state action values on all time steps. However, if it's a state action value that doesn't actually correspond to the current state action pair that we just experienced, then we just set the learning rate to zero, right? So that just means leave the Q values alone, except for in the state action pair where you actually just experienced and got a transition.
Okay.
This is the beginning of the statement of the theorem. So we're going to say B is going to be some contraction mapping. So this is going to be the Bellman operator ultimately. Q star equals BQ star. That's the fixed point. That's the solution to the Bellman equation. So Q star is like Q star.
Okay.
And let's imagine that we've got some sequence of Q functions that starts off with Q zero. And the way we're going to generate the next step from the previous step is we have a new kind of operator, B sub T. B sub T is going to be applied to Q sub T, producing an operator that we then apply to Q sub T. And that's what we assign Q T plus one to B. So in the context of Q learning, this is essentially the Q learning update, but we're going to separate out the two different Q functions that are used in the Q learning update. One is the past Q function that we're using to average together to take care of the fact that there's noise in the transitions. And then the other Q function is the one that we're using in one step look ahead as part of the Bellman equation. But we'll get to that in a moment. But here's the cool thing, that this sequence of Q functions, starting from any Q0 that we want, as long as we keep applying this, is going to go to Q star, yay, as long as we have certain properties holding on how we define these B sub T's.